Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. Decided I'd want to do another suggestions paintings. These are paintings, as I said, where I just, in an abstract expressionist manner, react to the way the colors are appearing and moving around. And then if something, a shape shows up, I go with it. I wanted to point out from the last one what happened, because it just amazes me how so many times something very precise does show up. Okay, right here where the dog's head is. All right, I added the eye and the ear, and that. That's it. This, even the mouth, showed up, little marks on the nose, showed up while I was painting. And that's just so fascinating. That's why I love doing this. It's just such a fun experience. And I'm real pleased how the colors turned out, too. I mean, don't think that I'm not considering this a painting, that just because of the approach. It's still very important to me how it turns out, and I wouldn't put anything in my portfolio that I don't think is good. And then right down here, that is the shape I saw of a duck. I did add the eye. Lots of times the eye shows up in the right place, like this one, which really amazes me. And then there's a bird right here, and that beak. The beak was exactly like that, up, lifting up. So, do it again. I've got a few different colors today, some darker ones. Don't know if that's gonna make a difference or not, but I just thought I would. I always like to experiment, as I said. Most of my work is not real experimental. But with these YouTube ones, I really like to just really have some fun. All right, so I'm going to really let the paint move around and maybe go back into it as it dries. But I've noticed, as I said before, that if I let the paint move around, my chances of something happening good are much better than if I get more towards precise shapes and all, more of a color field effect. I'm just gonna do it. Try not to. Usually when I do this, I just can't help, because I can't help but react to it very early as something to be looked at for its own sake. You know, how the colors are coming out, and I'm making lightning reactions to that. But I'm going to try not to do that so much and just paint. But I am doing what I do with my oil paintings, is using a lot of colors at the same time, which is not something I was ever taught. I don't think I'd ever teach somebody that. But it's what I've developed as an artist. It's my unique approach, I think. I don't know anybody else that does that. Probably there are some. Anyway, another good thing about doing these is that I don't usually want to go back into them. Lots of times when I do paintings for YouTube, I want to go back into them, and I've got so many other things to do. I did put these colors out, so I'm going to use them. As I said, I put some different colors out, so I'm going to use them right now. But, as you know, getting back to what I said, is that with these, I usually, oh, we could. I usually say, you know, that's it. I'm going to bring out these shades, but usually what happens is it turns out really nice. Oh, good. I'm glad I'm using a darker color. I think that will make a difference to how this works. So I tend to use light colors. My main work, as I've said many times, even though it's unique to me, it does harken back to expressionism and impressionism, and they tended to use just light colors, especially impressionists. So yeah, I do tend to avoid dark colors. But I've noticed that some of my best paintings have extreme contrast. That probably goes back to the fact that I love the Baroque era. God, there's nothing like that era. And that those paintings tend to have very, very strong contrast, mainly because of the type of lighting that they had in those days with candles and things. And just really, really intense lighting effects. So I've noticed that some of my landscapes, Evening Flight is one that comes to mind, that has really strong contrast. It usually, it just turned out really nicely. I think it just stands out so well. Okay, now, I'm not seeing anything yet. But I'm kind of liking what's happening. Well, I'm just going to keep going for a while. And I'm real excited about the fact that we are moving into a bigger house. Usually as people get older, they downsize. Well, it's not that we have a lot of stuff, because I've always made sure we don't. I move things out. But I need a bigger studio. And my husband, with all his research, he is a naturalist, well-known naturalist in New River Valley, all his research, he needs more room too. They need lots of room. All their books and their research, and you know, you can't get it all on the computer. Take forever. So I gotta move my water. This water has gotten so dirty. I'm glad I've got another one right here. Better talk loud so you can hear me. But this studio that I'm gonna have is gonna be twice the size of what I've got now. So that's really cool. Or twice the length. And I'm really looking forward to that because I am getting kind of squished in here. Always have been. It's really kind of a small studio. All right, I don't know what I'm doing at this point. I'm not seeing anything. Lots of times, as I said, it waits, it's at the end as it keeps on bleeding around, which I'm not letting it happen. Enough of that happened, probably. So let me just put some water in it. Just kind of takes a shape the way clouds do. You know, let me just add some water. And so what I say, the great thing about acrylics is that it dries so quickly that you can move to the next stage so fast, unlike oils. Although if you do keep it, if you have it really, really thin, you don't add oil, you just use mineral spirits to thin it down. It can dry really quite fast too. I'm not really seeing anything. Oh, crud. Last time, after a while, I really did see that dog's profile just came right out with the eye, with the nose, on one side. All right. Well, you could kind of take that as a guppy with the eye right there. Fish, as I said, they tend to really show up just because of, mainly because of the way I'm putting the paint on. Well, this may turn out to be a center of my mind paintings, a music without words paintings, paintings that you either like or you don't like just because of the way they look, but not because of what you like to see. If I keep doing those swirl things, I'm just going to see little things that can turn into fish. So let me just kind of do different things. Oh, I'm not really seeing anything. Also excited about getting ready for this move. We do need to buy a few new things. And yesterday, I think it was yesterday. No, the day before. My husband and I went to look for a king-size bed. We have a queen-size, and we really like a king-size, more room. And we wanted to get one that matched our really pretty oak furniture. We went to a store and could not find it. And the guy there said, you know, you just really can't find oak and maple anymore. Ah, didn't like that. And then we went to a much larger store and found one, just one. And I mentioned that to the lady there, and she said, yeah, well, he's right. It is really hard, but that's why we've just got this one. So pleased. So now we can have that and have the king-size bed that matches exactly what we already have, because we didn't want to get new dressers and stuff, because we got some really nice ones. Okay. Well, it's getting really complicated, but I don't see a darn thing. I hate that when nothing really just sticks out, because that's just so much fun. I like what's happening, though, in terms of an abstract painting. It's got a real nice, what do you call it? It's kind of cascading over to the right, and then there's these accents over to the left, which is really nice, but darn it. I don't really see a thing to work with. I mean, I'd have to make something up, I think. Oh, well. Fool around with a little bit more. And then just decide on a center of my mind painting. There's certainly nothing wrong with that. I mean, I like that too, very much. And this is getting really complicated. I like that. I was just hoping really something, a very definite shape would show up. But I still don't see anything except for maybe like a, you know, some fish that I could easily turn into fish. Oh, well. Well, you need a little more water. See if anything will happen. And then I might just say, center of my mind, using without words. See, as I use the water, though, I'm losing a lot of some really nice brushwork and color patterns that I liked, so that's kind of hard to do. I do like the way it has a definite focal point right through here. Paintings usually, not always, you've got to watch those always things, usually have one center that is what we call the focal point, regardless of whether it looks like something or it doesn't look like something in abstract, and everything else kind of works around that. And that certainly has developed as focal point right there, so I don't want to mess it up. Mainly because it's so light and the rest of it's kind of dark. It's just really standing out. Okay. Thought there might be something showing up there. If anything's going to show up, I think it's going to be a really tiny, tiny little shape. Maybe it'll happen when it dries. but I kind of think I'm going to be skunked this time. I don't see anything showing up that I can work with. Not a bird, not a duck, not a dog. I really don't see a thing. Maybe when it dries, something will show up. Said many times, one time I was so sure there was nothing, and then when it dried, I saw a fox. I mean, really, a fox running at the top. And I wasn't making that up or exaggerating or anything. It was just really there. All I had to do was just kind of outline it. Well, maybe I'll just fool around with it in terms of a abstract painting. I think it could use a little more contrast, a little more variety. And maybe something will show up. As I said, I've noticed when I don't, if it's not bleeding so much, it usually doesn't happen. But not always. I think I'm going to have to say forget it. I really do like the way it's turned out, though, as an abstract painting. I think it's got some really nice places. These little marks of the red are turning out very nice. I know that probably doesn't make a lot of sense, but, you know, if you paint all the time, it would. Painting is something that I think you understand more as you do it than any other way. And like I told my students, you're always changing. You're never going to get exactly what you want, and you don't. But you can get real close. And lots of times ones that age start to look really great. I think that's really nice. I have a number that I wasn't real crazy about when I did them. Look at them now and say, what was I upset with? Good grief, that's got so many strong points. There may be a little something here, but I could easily change that. And that's really a great experience. I see some online that I've sold, and I have sold a lot of paintings. Oh crud, I forgot. I'm always forgetting. Did I say at the beginning, please like and subscribe? Oh well, saying it now. For anybody that just has the time to watch this whole thing, please like and subscribe and share. What was I saying? I forgot. I know I was talking about how if you work hard, you can get close. And I have some that, I like that right through there. I have some that wasn't happy with. I look at them online and think, wow, what was the problem? And that's neat. That's why it really is a very hopeful thing, a very good thing to know if you are a painter. Because if there are any painters watching this, you know what I'm talking about. You keep changing, you keep progressing, and it's really hard to really get what you want because you keep changing, and it's just difficult, especially if you're doing things that are very complicated, lots and lots of colors. You can get it to a certain point, and then you change it, and then, oh, God, I lost what I liked was better. What I had was better, and now it's gone. And it's not an easy process. Anybody that thinks painting is an easy process, don't want to be rude or anything, but they all paint. And it doesn't matter which level, representational, abstract, or what we like to call non-objective when you don't really see anything. We like to call paintings that have shapes but have been purposely changed to be abstract. But, you know, what's wrong with just calling things that don't have anything, so what we call pure art or non-objective or non-figurative. Yeah, what's wrong with just calling that abstract, too? All right. I really like what happened, though, in terms of a painting, but I don't see a darn thing I can work with in terms of suggestion painting. That kind of looks like a funny little fish right through there. But other than that, I really don't see anything. I might just quit right now. I'm going to add a little more yellow. I've noticed with my abstract paintings, it really helps to have lots of yellow. Don't ask me why. It just tends to do that. It tends to really add a lot. Really accent it with yellow. And I really like that focal point there, so I want to pull that out. But don't want to overdo it. So that's it. Zillions of decisions. Zillions of things that happen. Most artists, it's a balance between control and accident. Do I change that? I'm going to lose that if I do. It's not easy, but it is wonderful and it's exciting. And I am so glad that I live to paint. And it's been 14 minutes. I think I'm going to quit now. I'm afraid I am going to lose what I've got by overworking it. And I do like what I've got. Well, do you see anything? No, I don't see anything. I can always pick out some fish, but that's about it. I was hoping that something really definite, really precise, and different would show up. Don't like that right there. Oh, that's better. All right, well, I think this is definitely going to be a center of my mind, music without words, painting. Thank you so much for watching. There will be a link to the final painting. As I've always said, you really can't see the colors that well in my YouTube. And there will also be a link to my Etsy shop and other sites with my work.